stop shorting Bitcoin. I hope that you're doing very well, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to today's cryptocurrency technical analysis, where I am going to be going through the Bitcoin chart and going over the short squeeze that is occurring. As I've started off the premise of this video, that is stop shorting Bitcoin. Wow. This is what I have been preaching to my team. There is absolutely zero reason to be shorting Bitcoin. The reason, what trade should you be looking for? Since we broke 17,500, longs, really simply longs. Why is this? I want to cover some reasons. So we obviously had our mini range down here. We broke out of that range. And since breaking that range, there has been zero signs to short. What have we been doing here? We have been building our low, high, higher low, higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low, higher high. You know, the trend is up locally. The trend is up on a high term time frame. Let's think for a minute. Who is shorting this? Who is shorting this, ladies and gentlemen? I have a few ideas. Why is the volume so low? Yeah, I'm trying to remember, you know, a lot of questions that I get asked during the day. Why is the volume so low, Daniel? Why is the open interest not following? Why are we rising in the way fashion that we're rising? Why am I only interested in longs? Why am I not taking short positions? These are questions that I've been asked quite a few times today by the Champions Group. And I'm going to give you some perspective to everybody else here on YouTube of why this is. Why has this been the most perfect short squeeze, period? Well, let's cast our minds back to the decline in price that we had. Okay, the decline in price that we saw was almost, we can say, orchestrated. And the reaction that we've had from this has been nothing short of very bullish. Let's just say that, okay? I'm going to try and be a bit mean to be nice, almost. We had a range down here at the lows, okay? Where we ranged from the low to the high to the low to the high to the low. When you break the range here, okay? When you break the range, what are you doing at this moment in time? You're saying to yourself, we have had a really bullish break from the low of the range. We know that we bounced off of the CC, which was obviously a Fibonacci pull from the low of our last pivot low to the last pivot high. We know that come into the CC support. And then we've seen a move out of the range. So I think a good trader that is not having a bearish bias nor a bullish bias, but trading the charts, views this as a long position. So a trader that has mastered his emotions would view this as a long, period. What have you done? You've put in a basing pattern on the CC and then you've broken out of the range. That is bullish. What are the majority doing on this? I truly feel that the majority throughout this period have missed the long down here, which I do not even think was bad. You could have missed the long down here, but the opportunity to long was 17,500, 17,600, the break of the range. You know, you could have longed here and you're still up 8%. But instead, people have been revenge trading this. What do I mean by that? People missed the long down here. Again, that's acceptable. It's fine. But what you don't want to do then is keep shorting and 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 shorting. I mean, it's absolute brain dead trading. The only people shorting right now are absolute brain dead traders or people that trade on Twitter. You know, I'm sure you're seeing people on Twitter saying this is a good short right now. Let me tell you this, it's not a good short right now. It's absolutely far from a good short. I mean, even while I've been making this video, we've moved up another $50 odd. I mean, it's just absolutely brain dead to be shorting this. And I'm sorry, but I have a real big passion for this. And I truly feel that there's so much people that just do not know how to trade and they have a voice. You know, these people have a voice on platforms such as Twitter and YouTube, and they just have no idea what's going on. This is a short squeeze, period. Okay. Let me refer you to some of my posts. Just from 10 a.m. this morning, I would say the volume is low, as too many are scared to buy or they're in disbelief of the rally. You know, it's absolutely still bullish. You know, why is there low volume in all of this section? Why have we been moving up on relatively low volume? People are absolutely scared. You know, scared money don't make money. If you are so scared and you're sat there on the sidelines, if you're sat there in a times one short, if you're sat there just in tether, too scared to take any longs, you're gonna be not making money. The opportunity here is is to jump in with the trend that's occurring right now, okay? That is not trying to short every rise, but that's trying to long each dip. Let me refer you to a post this morning. Literally 9:30 a.m., the long taken at $18,389, okay? It's the exact same pattern as the last few days, and this is where I'm pretty good at recognizing these sort of patterns, if I say so myself. The long literally was taken at the almost low of the day, and that was on the pullback. Well, ladies and gentlemen, what happened here? Once again, the price dropped down here, okay, between really 18,400 to 300, and it trapped shorts. People got massively aggressive on the shorts. Look at this. 4 million, 7 million, 3 million, 1 million, 2 million, 4 million, 3 million, 2 million, 4 million, 2 million, 1 million, 3 million shorts at support. These people are scared out their mind. I swear they're scared out their mind thinking, right, this is falling down now. I need to be in the short position, where I am flipping that on its head. I'm saying this is the first, this isn't, well, this, as I quote myself, it's the same pattern as the past few days. People keep on trying to short the breakdown. People keep trying to short the high instead of doing what they should be doing and longing the dips. Guess what? That was a long from 18,390. We now sit at almost $19,000. Stop shorting Bitcoin if you like to make money. You know, do not be there, sat there, absolutely scared out your mind, thinking, I can't buy into this because it's got to go down. Or even worse than that, I must short this because this has got to go down. No, this does not have to go down. This does not have to go down. I mean, look at it. I've been speaking here another few minutes, and guess what? I'm still sat in my long position. Okay, amazing call. It was an amazing call because I recognize people are so dumb in cryptocurrency. You know, I think this is sometimes a good trade, but then I remember who I'm trading against. And truly, I believe the majority of the crypto market are so dumb money. And I mean this, and I'm trying to do this in honestly the nicest way possible, to be mean, I'm being a little bit mean or over-exaggerating almost, to really push this into your brain so you remember this. If you are one of the people that sat in a times one short, if you're somebody that's been short in all this rise, if you're someone that sat in Tether too scared to take a trade, let this video remind you of to trade the charts. Forget the bias, forget the emotions, trade the charts. Okay? Hopefully I can get that point across. What you have to think to yourself is, okay, this, you know, again, I want to recap, and I really want this to get into your mind. We had a big retrace. Yes, this retrace at the time, I absolutely agree, you could have been looking bearish down here. I mean, I was also looking for potential lower prices, but my way that I traded this is I was neutral. I was neither bullish nor bearish at these lows. I was neither bullish nor bearish. I was trading the chart. I had a range to trade. This was a massive, massive, massive range. I was acknowledging, if we break to this range, guess what? I'll look for lower prices. If we break the higher this range, guess what? I'll look for higher prices. I was in shorts from 19,000 plus. And I closed all of my shorts when we broke the higher range, because that was a break of the lower range off of support. Why was I not looking for a single short here? Because the market structure has just been making low, high, higher, low, higher, high, higher, low, higher, high, higher, low, higher, high, higher, low, higher, high. We can pull back here, make another higher low, and move on for another higher high. There's absolutely no reason why we can't do that. And the people that are shorting this are the people with too much of an ego, too much to say, okay, I'm going to trade with this trend. I don't care if I have a higher entry than anyone else. What I care about is making money. We're not in this to post screenshots. We're not in this to do anything other than making money. You know, that's why we trade Bitcoin, to make money, period. Okay, and you can't do that if you cannot control your emotions. So I feel that there's a lot of emotions flowing through the market. I feel that a lot of people are very scared. They're in disbelief. They feel that this has to go down, and dumb money essentially is shorting. And you can quote me on this. You know, a lot of my posts over the last few days inside of the Champions group have been, there is no reason to short. There is zero reason to short. Level to level, no reason to short. So that's kind of what I just wanted to bring you today. It wasn't so much technical analysis. It was more of a, what is going on? I mean, hopefully, if you follow me, you're not going to be in the category of people that have been continuously trying to short this. So I hopefully my followers have a little bit more sense, but, you know, wow, what can I say? Are we running into resistance right now? Absolutely, we are. You know, $19,200. Absolutely, this is a resistance. Can we reject from $19,100? Absolutely, we can. Can we reject from where we are right now? Absolutely, we can. You could have been saying this exact same thing during all of this last over $1,000 move. Absolutely, we can. But why don't you just wait? Why do you need to try and time the exact high? I mean, why do you need to do that? Do you want to try and time the exact high? I mean, just why? Why do you need to think to yourself, why do you need to time the exact high? Okay, I'm personally in long and I've been trading stops. And until I see the weakness, I don't need to try and short this. Does that mean instead of shorting 19,000, I end up shorting at a lower price of, let's say, 18,500 and I miss the top $500 of the short? Well, that's obviously going to happen when we reject, because I refuse to short when the momentum is like it is. Okay, I have a particular set of rules that I abide to, and over time, these are the rules that help me make money trading. Okay, I would be breaking every single rule in my book if I tried to short where we are now, and I acknowledge that means I cannot short a high. But guess what? In this context, in the context that we're in right now, I truly could not care less. Okay, I just couldn't care less if I missed the high of the short. It really does not bother me in the slightest, you know, and I feel that that's the mentality that you have to be in. If you want to be good at trading, you need to get into the mentality, or you need to have that emotional control to say, you know what, I don't care. It does not bother me. I'm in this to make money. I'm in this to take it from level to level. I'm in this to take the most probable trades. You know, I'm not in this to buy the exact low. I'm not in this to buy the exact high. I'm in this to make the middle 60%. You know, let's be honest. You didn't need to short up here. In my opinion, the highest probability short was from 19,150. You didn't need to long down here. The highest probability long was on the reclaim of 17,500. So you can see here, you didn't need to short up here. You didn't need to long down here. But if you had got the short from here to here, that's an amazing trade. If you got the long from here to here, that's an amazing trade. Or even we can take this down and say, let's say we get stopped out and it ends here. From here to here, you've got the middle 60% of the short. From here to here, you've got the middle 60% of the long. Why do you need to, and I'm talking about swing traders here, why do you need to be interested in this? Why do you need to be interested in this? Be interested in the middle percentage. That's where the money's made. That's where you got your highest probability trades. That's where you trade with momentum. You have your steps of confirmation. That's everything you need. People trading the wicks up here, you know my opinion, who's trying to trade this. I think people on Twitter are trying to trade it, you know. I am so happy that I left social media in terms of Twitter and things like this. I'm not going to rant on about it, but I just wanted to make this video to try and help somebody of just things. You know, the only thing that I see on Twitter is what people post in the Discord group. That's the only interaction I get with Twitter, when someone posts a screenshot. You know, I never ever log onto it, but some of those screenshots, and these are from big accounts, it just blows my mind that people with this many followers, you know, probably put money behind what these people say, and it just absolutely blows my mind. It really does. So I suppose final words here are, I think this looks great. Do I think there's a reason to short? No, I don't. Do I think we're running into resistance? Yes, I do feel that we're running into resistance. That resistance is really 19,200. Do I need to short 19,200? No, I don't need to short 19,200. What can I do? I can wait for some confirmation that there's a high in at that level. You know, it's as simple as that. You know, it just really is. People make it seem so difficult and so complex, but at the end of the day, it's really not. It's really not. You know, yes, of course, there's steps that we can add complexity to trading, you know, adding in sort of the footprint charts, adding in, you know, when we're looking at our resistance support flips, you know, looking at these type of ranges. Again, this was a range from this morning that I gave to my team, you know, sculpt from the range low. You know, it's not that difficult. It really isn't. There's obviously, we can add layers of complexity, which gives us a higher probability trades. But I mean, at the core function, at the core of this, really not that hard. You just have to have your emotions in check. You need to make sure you make a plan and stick to your plan. and in the context. And I really want to remind you and emphasize this point once more. Context is so important. There are times where I will try and time a high with a short when I feel the context is fitting towards me. And that context does not include a short squeeze that we're in right now. Okay, that just does not, never would I try and short a short squeeze. I truly believe we're in short squeeze. Check my video from last night. I mean, literally the title of the video is "When Will the Short Squeeze End?" And we're up another $1,000 since I made that video yesterday. So yeah, I mean, what can I say? I just felt really compelled to make this video and I just want to remind you of, you could watch this video right now and we're sitting at $17,000 and you're like, wow, I mean, Dan, you could have shorted $19,000 and now if price is sat at $17,000, you know. And I'm going to tell you, you have to truly understand the way I trade is I could not care less. My short, instead of being 19,000, let's say it'll be 18,400. You know, yeah, I didn't short the high on this move, but guess what? If price pushes up, I can live with myself. I can sleep well. I can sleep at night knowing I've traded this from my plan, from my way of trading. I am telling the market what I want to do. Market can do what it wants to do, but I'm trading under my plans. I'm trading the way I want to trade. I'm not going to be influenced by anyone. I'm not going to be thinking left, right, and center. I'm not going to be thinking, overcomplicating this. I'm going to keep this as simple as possible. And as it stands, I'm making money. And that's the most important thing. That's why we trade. Thank you, everybody, so much. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. A little bit different than normal, but I just felt very compelled to make it. Hopefully, I've helped some people. Since I started this video, what, we're up another $100? I don't know. I mean, what can I say? Be aware we're running into resistance. Absolutely, this thing can drop, but let's just wait for a little bit of confirmation. Yeah, you don't need to try and time the high. Thank you, everybody, so much, and I hope you've enjoyed. Cheers. Thank you, and goodbye.